Welcome again to our parents, faculty, staff, and board members. And a special shout out to our students who have joined us tonight. This was a special request from our upper school students, and of course, we are very happy to have them. All right, let's get started. I think everyone approached August 31st with a mixed bag of emotions. Excitement to see everyone, no doubt about that. Anticipation of a new school year, which is pretty normal, but we added in the caution about COVID. When the day actually arrived, I actually was joyful myself, and it seemed as though a lot of the kids were very joyful. We've been attentive as we rolled out new procedures and put in a lot of extra hard work. It was, and occasionally still very much is, like riding a roller coaster every day, finding new ways to do our part as parents, teachers, students, and administrators. We appreciate you sticking with us and rolling with the changes together. I've been truly amazed at how quickly we're adapting every day. And it's gratifying to see how our community has pulled together during these very challenging times. So this slide is a quick look at what we'll be covering this evening. Our learning layer cake, it'll make sense later, extraordinary efforts, key dates, the gift of Westwood, ideas and resources, and then as always, finish up with our Q&A. All right, some of you might know, one of my favorite things to do is show my family and friends how special they are with a home-baked layer cake. I don't know why, but I've just always loved baking cakes since I was a child. There is something very personal about it. This cake here that you see in the slide is my rainbow cake. For me, baking a cake starts with thinking about who I'm baking it for and their unique tastes. This helps me put together my vision and plan to create a layer cake that's exactly right for them. The process reminds me a lot of Westwood's Montessori and IB approach to learning. We work closely with each child, getting to know their natural interests, and then plan a unique path to foster their learning development. We pave the way for the immediate next steps in their learning journey while preparing each student to excel in their future studies and personal development. Layer cakes are the sum of many wonderful ingredients, flavors, textures, and steps. Like the chocolate caramel cake I baked this weekend for a friend of my son's, it is important to take extra care of making the flavors, textures, filling, icing, and even the presentation work together to create a scrumptious layer cake. The drama of that particular cake, my rainbow cake, is all about the color. Of course, there's a lot that goes on behind the scenes of making a layer cake. As I've grown in skill, so has my utensils drawer, which I've had to clean out many, many times, and other specialty materials, although it's, you know, an easy gift to get me for the holidays. Making a layer cake is a labor of love that can seem overwhelming at first, but step by step, it comes together, like cultivating character in our children. It's important to know the steps, commit to them, and then most importantly, patiently follow them. It takes a lot of patience. So you see here the things that we think are the recipe for building character. The same way that I'm always looking for ways to make my layer cakes even better is the way we look out for our students, staff, and community. It's never the same at Westwood. We're always striving to do things the best way that we possibly can. With layer cakes, I'm often throwing a curveball or two, and that's a lot like Westwood life these days. We've stayed flexible and we figure out ways to adjust to handle things like the coronavirus that no one ever saw coming, or maybe some people did, but I didn't for sure. Throughout it all, we've kept our philosophy front and center, that learning is a personalized experience for each individual child. COVID-19 has forced us to find innovative solutions to deliver that experience. A lot of other institutions use personalized learning as this new buzz phrase, but Westwood has successfully been doing this for more than 30 years. While we can use technology as a tool, technology cannot shortcut the nurturing of relationships essential to educating the whole child. What we do every day is a labor of love for our students, community, and Westwood's legacy. Here in this slide are some examples of the extra efforts and sacrifices our school teachers and staff are making so our students can continue to learn during the pandemic. Obviously, one, caring for students, connecting in real time. I have to be 100% honest, I was really worried about all this, how this was all going to go. It's one thing in theory and then another in practice, and we weren't really able to practice very much. The extraordinary ability of our teachers, and I do mean extraordinary, to connect with each child, whether in the classroom or online, has been nothing short of an absolute joy to watch. Or to listen to. I listened the other day to one teacher patiently listen to and answer every child, including the one at the end that said, "Do you want to hear a joke?" Which she did, and it was a cute joke. Number two, all the online learning takes more effort on the teacher's part, and I know this firsthand because I'm actually teaching in the classroom right now. It's not just learning how to use the Google Classroom, but also finding an extension cord, figuring out the camera, and all the while wearing a mask for 8 or more hours and sanitizing absolutely everything. I've told everyone that I feel like I'm walking around with those Mr. Bottles, basically spraying the children so that nobody gets sick. We made a decision to cap class sizes for the fall to protect the health and safety of our community. And this means that we've had a budget shortfall this year. It's been particularly difficult because, of course, none of our expenses have gone away. Rather, we've had to increase resources to respond to COVID-19. We've pulled out all the stops to weather the financial and staffing impacts of coronavirus, such as spending, I'm not kidding with you guys, 85 man hours each week to staff and manage car lines and health checks. I always thought that we didn't do car line because we love to have the parents in the building, that maybe it was just really because Ms. Butler tried a car line and it was horribly difficult. But we're getting better. We're getting better at it. At lower school, we've also had to adjust to unexpected teacher changes related to the pandemic. It is difficult, it has been difficult right now to find qualified teachers and substitutes. But happily, we've found ways to organize our teaching team and everyone is stepping in to help. So you see here a couple of students with the laptop, actually real time, the kids are learning a lesson with the golden beads all together. Ms. Dittmer is doing a Spanish class here. And then I love the car line picture. So that's always a fun one. All right. We've looked for ways to help our families ease the extra pressures that they faced during the pandemic. And here's three ways we've continued to prepare our students for success in school and life. We've updated the Montessori Learning at Home boxes. And we've now added Montessori materials for our first graders. The number of hours have made for weeks of individually, hours have become weeks. I don't know how else to say how many hours and weeks have been spent individually cutting every single letter for the movable alphabet so the online learners can have them at home. And you see them here in the picture. They're absolutely incredible. The at-home teacher visits before school started helped our preschoolers and their parents feel more at ease the first day of school. And our online learning families also received coaching on how to use the boxes with remote learning. And if for some reason remote learning is mandated by authorities, we will continue to offer childcare along with online school. So we're doing everything we can to help. When we decided to offer families a choice between at-home and in-person learning, first I had no idea really what that meant, actually. But what we did know was how important it would be for learners, for the remote learners, to stay connected with their teachers and classmates. we saw in the spring how difficult that was and how it hurt the kids. But we've received positive feedback for our efforts, including hiring Mr. Terrell as our director of distance learning. So he's always there, ready to answer questions as needed. Rolling out the Google Classroom training for our students and our parents. So a special shout out and thank you to Ms. Resnus and Mr. Terrell for doing that. And then Mr. Terrell sends online specific emails with updates and additional assistance as needed. I love this picture here because if you'll notice, this is like the perfect setup for a child at home learning. She, you know, is completely surrounded and has a good space, good light. She has all her materials there. This is a great setup. Okay. It's important we all work together to stay safe during the pandemic. Of course, that's a top priority. To help us do this, we've developed a package of communications to keep you in the know. We have three communications. The 2020-2021 COVID-19 Health and Safety Guidelines. That is sort of like a handbook and it's full details. The fall 2020 COVID-19 safety update for each campus, which is like a one-page summary. Then we have the frequently asked questions, which has gotten quite long because we've put in every question that parents have asked. And also we will have a webpage completely dedicated to COVID-19 and it'll be launched next week. We've worked hard to make these guidelines work for our Westwood community and we plan to stick with these decisions, but we really appreciate your patience and cooperation on that front. Okay, here's a quick look at some key dates from now through the beginning of our spring semester. So you'll see here, some of these have changed. If you go to the westwoodschool.org/calendar link, it will give you all the updated dates. We have picture days. The conferences slightly changed. Those will be all Zoom conferences. You should be getting signups for those in the next week. I think in the next week. October 17th, we have a Chinese Autumn Festival with a group that we belong to, and our Chinese club will be participating. I'm very excited. Of course, it's an online event. It starts at 9:30, and we'll send out some information about that so that you can see our Chinese club members and their special performances. And then throughout here, you'll see some open houses and parent previews, which we'll talk about a little bit more in a moment. We do have, we've changed homecoming week. That will be a fun week for everyone at home and at school. And then we plan on having a high school homecoming event on Halloween Day, because probably they're not out trick-or-treating when they're in high school. Then our Thanksgiving feast, just want to point out that we did add back into the calendar Monday and Tuesday to help us with the COVID-related days that may happen where we may be out of school. And so we have a three-day Thanksgiving holiday this year. So I want to make sure everyone realizes that. And then we will have our regular early release and winter break with childcare on the first day that the teachers come back. So of course, always if you have any questions about these, please call the office. Somebody will help you with them. I also did want to mention, to make sure everyone knows, the athletic calendar. We do have a volleyball team. I know it's like a miracle, but we do have a volleyball team and they are playing three more home games. Last night they played their first home game. And of course, it's always great to see the kids. I've mentioned before how much I love that. But what surprised me last night was seeing the parents. I got to see probably 20 parents, and every single parent that walked in the door, I would have hugged, but we couldn't hug. And it really made me realize how much I miss everyone. I think that in this time, we obviously have to think about our kids, but we also need to think about ourselves and how can we stay connected. I think it's so important. And it was really great fun to see everybody last night. So if you can come out to the game, we do have a limit of 60 people that can be in the stands, but hope to see you there. All right, we'll move on. We're incredibly grateful for you supporting us with the Giving Day campaign, which was just last week and also a lot of fun. More than 3/4 of our community participated with a gift to the school, and we raised a little over $70,000. So thank you so much. I had no idea what to expect. So it was a very welcome and grateful thing that we're very grateful for. Your gift will support the school's current financial year operating budget. And it particularly is helpful this year, given that revenue that we've sacrificed and investments we've made related to COVID-19. And of course, I do want to give a special thank you to our Giving Day Chair, Tricia Stewart. She has probably done this, I guess, for the last 3 years, maybe 4 years. And she is just so happy and her smile is so bright. It's a joy to work with her and to have her around on that day all day. So thank you, Tricia. I think of my layer cakes as a gift from my heart. It reminds me that Westwood is a gift, the legacy passed on from those who have come before us, like Maria Montessori, Pam Butler, our founder, teachers, staff, students, parents, grandparents, and others who've shared their time, talent, and treasure over 3 decades to shape Westwood's legacy of character, community, and excellence. In particular, I'd like to point out the center photo of 3 young ladies who actually all started kindergarten together. And 2 of those same young ladies, just a tiny bit to the right and up, having a bridal shower. So one of them is getting married, the other one is in her wedding, and the reverse happened as well. So those friendships endure over a long period of time. We also have hired some Westwood graduates, which is really things coming full circle. Shelby Navalta earned her AMI certification and is currently working on her master's degree at SMU. And we hired her to work in our preschool environment. And then we have another Montessori graduate, Rachel Brumbelow. She is working in the UE Upper Elementary Language and Literature class. She graduated from one of our favorite Houston Montessori schools, School of the Woods. They came before us in the high school adventure, and we went down to visit them, and we absolutely love that school. So the legacy of Montessori lives on. And I'm so thankful for the gift of Westwood. I'd like to invite you to join me to carry the gift of Westwood forward to future generations, like others have done for us. You might be wondering what you can do now to carry the gift of Westwood. If you participated in Giving Day with a gift to Westwood, that's a fantastic start. If not, your gifts, of course, are always welcome. Anytime you'd like to give more, we will never turn you down. Inviting friends to join us for events that I had mentioned before is another great way to help. You see here our open houses and our preschool previews that are online, several different ways that you can invite people to see the Westwood School. And keep an ear out for friends and family who would be a great fit for Westwood, and refer them to one of our current openings. You can see here our available spots. We had to close our Toddler 1 classroom, but we would like to reopen in January. We have all these openings here, 6 in preschool, 7 openings in 4th or 6th grade, 5th grade completely full, which is really nice. 7th grade has 6 openings, 8th grade 1, 9th grade 4, and 10th grade 5. So if you know anyone, then we will gladly see if they're a good fit for Westwood. And then we're currently considering ways to make up this budget shortfall and welcome ideas and assistance. We'll be talking more about that as time goes on. And then a final thing before we go to question and answer, we'd like to share four articles we thought you might be interested in. So from Healthy Children, published by the American Academy of Pediatrics, one article about screen time. Everyone needs a break from their computer, so that's a great article to look at. And then Mask Mythbusters. There's a couple other articles on mental health, which again, we've stressed and is so important for our kids. So those are good articles to read and things to watch for with your kids in the event that they are not feeling great. Thank you for joining us, and most of all for being a valuable member of our Westwood community. I hope that we'll keep moving forward together and we can answer Q&A.